slightly extended crank time? This is the issue we'll be dealing with in this proper repair video. The easiest way to get a direction is via scan tool. See if we have any codes. And indeed there is, P0340, camshaft position sensor A. This is a generic OBD code, let's see if BMW specific agrees with that. Okay, basically the same description, just now we know that this will be the sensor on the intake side. And since we have the scan tool ready, let's check the ignition timing. It's slightly retarded at idle, and when I give it a throttle snap, it's somewhat sluggish and the timing doesn't advance as much as I would expect. So we definitely have an issue. The way the sensor works is very simple. It gets battery voltage on pin 1, 5 volts on pin 2, and ground on pin 3. When metal is in the proximity of the sensor, like a camshaft gear, we should see 5 volts on the signal wire being pulled to the ground. Otherwise, 5 volt DC reference voltage should be maintained. So, let's check if our wiring is in order. On pin 1, we've got 12 volts. On pin 2, 5 volts, as expected. And there is no resistance between pin 3 and the ground. Just to be sure, we can also check that there is no weird voltage drop. And since our test light is bright when connected to pin 1, we can say that everything to the connector is okay. Testing the sensor on the car would be difficult, since we cannot really backprobe the connector or even easily pierce the wires. So I've got power source, the sensor, DVOM, and some fake crankshaft gear. First, let's test the resistance. 0.8 kOhms seems reasonable. Now let's give it some juice and grab some iron. We see some voltage is induced, and even more so when we switch to AC voltage. This is a working sensor from a different car. Actual test pulling the 5 volts to ground would be a bit more challenging. I'll be showing the change on an E46, but the process is similar to any BMW with this engine. Take off air intake and air fill the housing. Disconnect venous solenoid and remove it. You'll need a 32mm wrench. Now the sensor is exposed. Take a 5mm Allen to unscrew it. If you've got some blue Loctite, add it to the screw before putting it back. The connector for the sensor is down there. The new sensor, made by Hella, is slightly different in design, but it should work just fine. Pass the cable down the rabbit hole. Add some original Loctite and screw it in. I'll just do it hand tight, as there is no way to fit a torque wrench in there. Also, don't forget to plug it in. Now it's just the time to put everything back together. How long does it take to start an M54 engine in ideal conditions? Pretty quick! Okay, let's scan for codes and see if they come back. They didn't, so that's good. And how does the timing advance look? It spikes at 37.5 degrees, which makes more sense, and the engine response is considerably better. Problem fixed!